Hey guys, Dana Jacovello here, founder of Bullies Keep Out. We had some people come to us and suggest that we talk to everybody and spread a message of love and kindness in regards to some cyberbullying that we've been seeing within fandoms due to some recent announcements. And of course, we always talk about fandom bullying because we work with a lot of celebrity advocates on a lot of different shows. The most we have that we've had been blessed to work with and that we know and that have become friends is a lot of people from the show Once Upon a Time. And everybody knows that we work with a lot of them and or have their support or they've shown support. And it's been amazing. And I am certainly thankful and grateful for the show for many reasons, that being one of them. But I see so much negativity and hate and anger lately due to recent announcements of a show that's about hope and love and spreading beautiful messages. And not for nothing, but also a cast that is incredibly talented and humble and has been with us for 6 years and have given their heart and souls to the show and cons and the fans, and they constantly show love consistently and they almost never falter when it comes to that. They're one of the most pleasant casts I've ever met, ever worked with, ever had the pleasure of knowing, calling some of them friends. You know, and I don't think we appreciate that enough when we're attacking writers, producers, actors, bullying them, saying hateful things, but yet in the next another sentence, how much you love them, how much you admire them. If that was true, then you wouldn't be saying the things that you're saying. You'd have respect, you'd show love and kindness back. And we put people on pedestals. We don't want them to be human beings. They're not allowed to make mistakes. God forbid they fall or they do something, you know. And there's too much questioning and entitlement issues and emotional blackmail and just too many things going on that shouldn't happen. Fandoms are about support systems, making new friends, relationships, love, and you know, just being together as a group and appreciating the show and the beauty of a show for what it is. And for the most part, they are. But there's also a lot of toxicity that I'm seeing. And that has been going on for a while. But recently, I mean, attacking media personalities and, you know, making comments. I'm not watching this. And da-da-da-da and blah, blah, blah. And, I, you know, don't watch it or watch it. Be a fan or don't be a fan. But don't complain. And every little thing doesn't have to be voiced all over Twitter, bringing people down, spreading negativity, spreading hate, bullying. It's comment after comment after comment. Okay, fine, we get it. And, you know, have an opinion, have conversations with your friend privately or even on, you know, posts. But do it with kindness and respect and love. And respect the actors that are still there, that are going to bring you a season 7 and that are going to amazing people, amazing talent. And appreciate that the show is going to continue and be happy for them. And a show that you've loved for 6 years, it's not ending. Wait and let's see what happens before everybody just starts falling apart. And it's not an entire fandom, because that's a problem too, where everybody says, oh, it's this ship, it's that ship, it's these shippers, it's that ship. That needs to stop too, because it's people. It's not necessarily ship related. This show has become ship wars. Everything's about ships. Show is not about a ship. Yes, there's relationships on shows. That's not all they're about. They're about stories and background stories and messages, and they inspire and they motivate. Television can be very powerful, and the actors who play them can be, and very inspirational and motivational. We know that from this cast. We see it all the time. I see it all the time. And it's really sad and disheartening to see that all that is being forgotten over recent announcements. You know, shows move on. They make creative decisions. People leave shows. It happens. Not saying it's wonderful. Not saying everybody, not saying we have to like it. We can't be sad about it. But we also have to wish the best for people in their future endeavors and respect decisions and not fall apart and just be horrible over Twitter and spread that type of behavior. Because I don't think there's need for behavior. And all the memories that have come in the past 6 years and what the cast has given to their fans, which has been tenfold, and we know that from cons and from going to sets and seeing them around town, and it's just however you've connected with them, we know that it's a very humble, a very approachable, very beautiful, loving cast, And nobody can say that that's not true. But you know, I just it's tiring to see. A lot of people agree with it. People that we work with, advocates, have seen it. They see the negativity that's been said. We all know it. Panels, that's been said. It won't be tolerated. But yet, claiming to be fans and loving and admiring them, and then as soon as they turn their heads, it's the same people who are saying that and standing up for causes of bullying and hate are doing everything that the people that they look up to are against. So it's basically like saying, I love you, and then when that person turns around, you are talking about them behind their back. So it's really no different. It's disrespectful. It's really not appreciated because there's so many people that are trying to be positive and that are trying to enjoy, you know, the show, and they're spreading that kindness and love, and they're waiting to see what happens and what's going to be the future, and they almost don't want to, you know, you almost wonder why people don't come on Twitter anymore and interact as much, or there's not as much interaction, or people have left Twitter, and I've seen it, tons have, and they've done it with even more than one show. People have left. They've actually gone off Twitter because of these situations, and you almost sometimes can't even blame them. I wouldn't want to deal with it on a daily basis either. And so you ruin a good thing. You take everything, all the good memories, and we're just like stomping on it and walking all over it. And why would we want to do that after 6 years? When this show first started, none of this was happening. I don't remember any of that. And then all of a sudden, it became about Chip Was. And let's not say that it's about causes and get all political, because it's not. It's about Chip Was and what people want and living and you and expecting these people to live up to our standards, and that's not right either. That's where humanity gets lost. They have private lives, they have personal lives. Feeling entitled that you need to know every reason why something is done, question every move they make, every tweet, every little mistake, every little thing is questioned. And how would you feel like if somebody had that type of microscope on you? And not appreciating the love that they give you, and as much as life, they give so much of their personal lives already, and it's just like more, 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 and then the good thing gets ruined. That has to stop. You have to have respect. There has to be lines. You know, you can't step over them. No emotional blackmail. Just enjoy it. Enjoy the show. It's entertainment. It's their job, and they love doing it, and we love watching it and enjoying it and interacting about it. But don't expect people to live up to your standards and to feel that they have to answer to you, and you have to delve so much into their personal lives, which nobody has a right to do. If they want to share something, they will. And it's just, you know, like I said, it's all over, and it's almost sometimes like it's getting worse. And like I said, for the most part, the fandoms are a beautiful thing, but when you see all this happening, it's really, there's really no other way to say it. It's unacceptable. There's no room for it, and it shouldn't be tolerated. And it's sad because the world is could be an ugly place, and we don't want to add to that. We don't want to make bullying and hate worse than it already is. Cyberbullying, any form of bullying. You know, if you look up to these people, look up to them and do it fully and be a full fan. Don't do things that you know is going to hurt. They are human beings. They are no different than us. They struggle. They have life problems. They are not immune to emotions. They have bad days. You do hurt them when they see these things, and it is hurtful. And you don't want to do that to people that everybody claims to admire and love so much and look up to, and they're idols, and I've seen so many people so appreciative, but yet still do some of these things. And it's just really not fair. It's not fair to them. It's not fair to you. It's not fair to the rest of the people in the fandom and that enjoy those actors and actresses and the shows. So all we want to say is be kind, love big. It's not that hard to do, guys. Make this a positive thing and appreciate the 6 years that we've had with an incredible ensemble and wait and see what happens and look forward to what is, you know, comes to the future, you know, what's going to come in that future and what we're going to see, rather than jumping to so many assumptions and conclusions before anything even happens. And please, again, just stay respectful. It's the most important message that we want to share and spread. Be kind, love big. Mwah.
Hello, my name is Mallory McDonald, and many of you guys may know me as a cosplayer in the Once Upon a Time fandom. I just came on here because alongside Bullies Keep Out, I've seen a lot of disheartening things happen with the fandom lately. And I do understand the way that you feel. Because, I mean, this is a show that really spoke to us since the beginning. It was a message of hope and love and pursuing who you are. So it was beautiful, beautiful, beautiful message that we all came and were a part of. Now that it is slowly this chapter coming to an end and some of the actors are leaving, and it's now being revamped into a new show, and in essence, this one is closing, I see a lot of people full-on attacking other people in the fandom, other people who work on the show, going after the actors, the creators, and the disheartening part is that we've, like, first of all, yes, this is a beautiful show, and it taught us a lot about love and hope and courage and strength and all of that, and maybe got us through a lot of the hard, difficult times in our own lives, but it is a show. It is foremost a form of entertainment, and I think what happened with this fandom is they clung so dearly to these characters that they forgot in essence that this was something that is going to come to an end. And whether or not you are going to stay with the show or whether or not you're going to say, you know, I'm done, that's completely up to you. But the bullying and the harsh picking on people needs to stop, because that's not what this show was ever about. And I know that different people will say different things to defend their points and say, oh, well, ships ruined the show or this and this and that and whatever. But I feel like the show has truly shown all things of life. And sometimes life is not fair. Life is not part of the happy ending. And that was kind of the whole purpose of the show, where, you know, in the first pilot episode, Regina says, you know, well, Regina as the Evil Queen says, we're going somewhere awful, which is here, you know, which was very ironic because, you know, like, we're here promising our happy endings and different things like that, but we're also hearing that there's no such thing as a completely fairy tale happy ending. I myself am married and I have a child, and so I feel like I've come to my happy ending as a person, you know, here in a place that doesn't have usual happy endings. Is it perfect? No, because life's not perfect. And this, I feel like the show really reflects that. Going forward, all the people that are going to stay with the show, I'm going to tune in because, you know, I want to see what happens, you know. I've been that way since I didn't start with season one. I started with season two. And so I want to see what happens. I want to see where they're taking it. Something in the fandom that really just kind of threw me off was I've seen other shows. I've never been this involved with the fandom as much as once. But one thing that I did see with this fandom is that there's that sense of entitlement. Adam and Eddie have worked on Lost. I watched Lost. I loved it. Did I love the ending? No. could I have thought of something else they could have done? Sure. We all have different ideas. Am I the creator of the show? No. So I had to just accept it. I accepted, okay, that's how they decided to end it. Same thing with other shows that I've watched. Dexter is another one. Did I think that was the greatest ending? No. And sometimes it's they sometimes these shows do an amazing job, you know, closing everything, tying all pieces, and sometimes they just don't have the time. They don't have they don't want that kind of ending, and that's their prerogative because they are the creators of this show. And I sense that in the fandom, people feel entitled. I deserve to see Regina with this person because I deserve to see Snow White on the next season because they were the ones who started it. I like all of this stuff that I see on Twitter and Instagram about I, me, type of thing. And even as an actor, these actors, you know, they have their own lives. This is their job. They are these characters that we love and adore. I know this cast especially loves their fans and have been so amazing to their fans and really have given back. You see all of these pictures of these Once Upon a Time casts with all of these fans. Whether or not you got to meet every single one or anything, they are there and they are out there and they are there for their fans. And as fans, we need to be kind of there for them. If you're leaving because of a certain actor, that's your prerogative. But don't tear down other people who are continuing to watch the show because their favorite actor is going to be on it or they want to see where the story is going to end. So yes, just, you know, you have your thoughts, I have mine, everyone is entitled to their thoughts, but you're not entitled to see your thoughts on the show. Those are the writers' jobs, those are the directors' jobs, those are the creators' jobs. And we have to kind of get away from this entitlement and I want this. And get back to the heart of the show, which is that hope, and take the things that we needed to hear in our lives and experience in these moments of our lives. I started watching the show, personally, this was my moment. I started watching the show because somebody told me, oh, you know, your doppelganger's on the show, you need to see it, and also she's a teacher, which is weird because you are. And I said, oh, that's so funny, sure, I'll watch it. And it was funny, and that's what got me starting to watch it. And as I delve into the stories and everything, my husband was on deployment because he was in the U.S. Navy. And so it kind of got me through that, like, that loneliness, you know? And it got me through that time, oh, I look forward to this every Sunday. And then even when he would port, he would kind of check in with me, and I'd tell him about the episodes, and we kind of connected that way. So it was really, really awesome. And it was a great experience in my life, and I will always be forever grateful for that connection that I had with my husband, who was overseas. He's back now, so that's good. And we watch it together now. I'm trying to think of anything else I wanted to talk about. We all put ourselves into these shows. I believe the same thing with music. I love music. And there's certain songs that will remind me of a certain part of my life, whether it was good or bad or ugly or whatever, it reminds me of that. So if I hear a song, I'm like, oh, I don't want to hear that because it reminds me of this. Or, oh, I turn it louder because it reminds me of something exciting that happened to my life. And so it's the same with TV. We see TV in a certain time of our lives. You get that connection with the characters. But we do need to realize these are characters, not actual people. And we can, yes, learn from their experiences, and yes, learn from their lessons. And I love that Once has applied this form of entertainment to a reality, to a certain extent, where they do parallel life, and they do teach lessons, and they do talk about things that really happen in today's world. So I just encourage you to either walk away from Once Upon a Time with that sense of completion, or that sense of peace, that sense of gratitude that you got to meet the people you did during this time with Once, that you got to connect with these actors who you probably maybe never knew before Once Upon a Time, that you got to be a part of this moment in time. You know, not everybody did. You know, there's people out there who don't know what Once Upon a Time is, and There's some people that are going to basically barely like start this new chapter of Once and not know the back, you know? So just be like grateful for everything that has come into your life and everything you have taken away, and try to focus on the positives. Because if you focus on the positives, you're going to be able to get that sense of, okay, I accept it, I'm done with it, I'm not going to watch it anymore, but let me go watch seasons 1 through 4, or whatever your favorite season or your favorite episodes were, and just take that away from it. If you take this negativity and this, oh, they should have done this, and I hate that they did this, and I hate that person, I hate that fandom, and whatever, then you're just going to have that struggle inside. It's just, it's the same as when people say forgiveness is not for you. It's not for them, it's for you. It's the same thing. Accepting it and accepting the positivity is not for them. You're not saying, oh, you're right for writing it that way, or I support your decision to get rid of these cast members. You're saying, for myself, I take what I want and I am at peace with it. I'm gonna have positivity from here on out. I'm not gonna put negativity out there, because where is it gonna go? It's just gonna hurt people's feelings. It's just gonna eat at you. So there's no place for negativity in this fandom or in your life. For those of you who are moving forward with the show, awesome. I will be posting my thoughts and everything going forward. And I hope that I get your response back and we can go through this together and see what crazy journey these three characters that we know for sure are going to be on it go through. That's all for now. I hope that you guys have a wonderful day. I don't know when you guys will be watching this. It's Sunday here, so it's Wednesday. So, yeah, be kind to each other. Spread positivity. Keep positivity in your heart. Take what you want. Throw away the rest. And